So hey guys, it's Emulator back at it with a $500 gaming PC build for July 2016. Now this PC is great at 1080p gaming at high settings. As you can see, it can play most games at 60fps at those settings like GTA 5 Hitman, and it can run CSGO at 152fps, which is pretty high, but CSGO is a pretty easy game to run anyways. In Ashes of Singularity, this PC does lag behind a little bit with only 30fps, but it still is playable. So let's get on with the rest of the build. For the CPU, it chose the Intel Core i3-6100 for $112. This is a dual core with hyper threading, making it act like a quad core. A lot of people think this is not good for gaming at all because it's only a dual core CPU, but I have this and this runs great in gaming. And it does outperform the FX6300 in a lot of games. It's also clocked at 3.7 GHz, which is a pretty nice clock speed. Unfortunately, it cannot be overclocked with most motherboards. Speaking of motherboards, I chose the ASRock H110M-HDS for $52. This has 4 SATA 6 gigabit ports, USB 3.0 headers, and 2 RAM slots. So this really has everything you need on a lower budget. And these Skylake motherboards do tend to be a little more expensive, so you can't really get much better than this at this budget. For the RAM, I chose a Crucial Ballistic Sport LT 8GB set for $30. This is a 1x8GB set clocked at 2400MHz. Now 8GB has been the standard for gaming for a while, and in video editing this should be fine. For the hard drive, it chose a Seagate Barracuda 1TB hard drive for $49. Now this spins at 7200 RPM, which is really mainstream, and this is going to serve as your mass storage for all of your games and media. For the GPU, it chose a Sapphire RX 480 for $199. This is the 4GB model, so it's going to be great at 1080p gaming. At 1440p, it's not going to be nearly as great, but it's still going to be doing good. Now this is a great value because at $200, it's in GTX 970 territory, which is about $70 more than this at the moment. This is probably one of the best GPUs AMD has released in the past 3 or 4 years. For the case, I chose a Corsair Speckle 1 for $40. Now this has a side window, front panel USB 3.0, and cable management holes, and it looks nice, so I would say this is probably one of the best cases at this budget. You can't really get much more than this, and it really is just a great, balanced case. For the power supply, I chose the EVGA 500B ATX power supply for $30. This is 80 plus bronze certified, meaning that 85% of the power is going to be going to this power supply at all times. It's also really reliable, and EVGA is known to have good capacitors as well. I also own one of these, and I have never had any problems with it. So that's all for today. If you liked the video, like it. If you hate everything about life, dislike it, and subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys later.